Hello, traders. Gary Wagner here. Approximately 120 in Honolulu, 720 in New York on Friday. Happy Aloha Friday, as we say on the islands. It is the 27th day of June, 2021, and this is the Daily Report for Gold and Silver, our weekend review, and what a week and what an ending to the week, capped off by a speech by Chairman Powell in which he made a distinguishing difference between when they would raise interest rates and when they would begin to taper. That appeased both equities and precious metals traders, taking both of those markets substantially higher. We'll cover ground on our current trade. We did issue a trade alert yesterday. We'll talk about that when we pull up our charts. But first, to today's price board. Federal Reserve Chairman Jerome Powell spoke virtually today at possibly one of the most important speeches he makes on an annual basis at the Economic Symposium, normally held at Jackson Hole, Wyoming, but because of the onset of the Delta variant, was held virtually this year. His tone, along with his words, expressed the hardship that the economy in the United States faced, as well as their current outlook, saying 17 months have passed since the U.S. economy faced the full force of the COVID-19 pandemic. This shock led to an immediate and unprecedented decline as large parts of the economy were shuttered to contain the spread of the disease. But the key takeaways from what he said, they are ready to begin tapering. However, he made a key distinction between the onset of tapering and the onset of raising interest rates, which he said is going to be determined by data, but had a much different data set of necessary components to begin to raise interest rates. That satisfied investors in both the safe haven asset class and investors that are looking at the equities markets, because typically there is a negative correlation between U.S. stocks and safe haven assets such as gold and silver, except for the rare instances when an extremely accommodative Federal Reserve will result in the stock market moving to higher ground and gold and silver moving to higher ground. And that is exactly what we saw today. Gold futures closed sharply higher, up $25.30, a net gain of 1.41%, currently fixed at $1,820.50. If you recall, we sent out an official trade alert, although we have been talking about it all week, yesterday, to tell our subscribers to initiate long positions in both gold and silver. Our traders taking the call in the case of gold got in at $1,795 per ounce, and we covered the full distance of today's $25 upside move. The only markets that really experienced downward ticks was the U.S. dollar, which lost approximately 0.4%, currently at 92.68, as well as yields going lower. Now, markets such as the NASDAQ Composite and S&P closed at new all-time record highs, NASDAQ closing at 15,129, and the Standard & Poor's gaining about 0.9%, closing at 4509. These are new records for both of those indexes. I believe that the single most important takeaway from today's virtual speech by Chairman Powell was their distinction as to the criteria needed to begin to taper their asset purchases and a different set of criteria to begin to raise rates. We obviously had a major breakout in gold as it surged past 1800, closed above both the 100 and 200-day moving averages, and closed just off of the high, 1820.50, and the high was 1821.90. Now, in terms of levels, now that we're positioned ourselves from the long side, that we want to look at, the first area, since we're over all of these major moving averages, going to be looking at these tops that come in right here. And as you can see, they come in at roughly, call it 1838 to 1840. That's going to be one key area. If it simply barrels through that, you've got 0.618% Fibonacci retracement, 1827. So we'll say that there's going to be a band of mild resistance, I believe, between this particular price point area. And then 1866, that is the 78% retracement. And realize, traders, that we are looking at a data set that begins at the first week of June, when gold was at 1920, down to the lows achieved on August 9th, when we had a virtual flash crash or meltdown in the market. And that's what makes these different Fibonacci levels so critically important. So the next area we want to look at is around 1830 to 1838. Following that is going to be 1866. And then, of course, the first brass ring would be a move back above 1900, 1920, being the brass ring itself. Traders, maintain your current long positions that we put in on gold yesterday. We will look to trail our stops up as appropriate. The trade alert that we sent out yesterday also had a specific recommendation to enter long silver positions. Now, we did go into the September contract. $24.03 is the current fix after factoring in today's 2% gain. However, we are going to roll that into a December position either Monday or Tuesday of next week. And as always, we will send out our trade alert via SMS text message as well as emails. Traders, as you know, we also sent out a trade alert recommending the initiation of a silver position from the long side. As I said, we did go into the September contract. The market was trading at 23.56. That was our entry price. Our stops are sitting at 22.80. It currently is at $24.06. So we have profits. It is above the 78% Fibonacci retracement. That is a key and critical level, as I've talked about in the past. And we will look to trail our stops higher. But first, as I said, we are going to roll that into a December position. Now, in terms of current levels of resistance, if the market continues to move up, the first area that we want to look at comes in at about $24.50. It's based upon this low, and that's followed by $25.11 based upon the 61.8% Fibonacci retracement that also corresponds to the 50-day moving average at $25.07. Maintain your current position till next week. We will send out a special trade alert recommending that you roll that into a December contract. This has been Gary Wagner wishing you, as always, good trading. We will talk to you on Monday for the next daily update and review. Bye-bye.